The 48-day Living Enlightenment Process at Bidadi Ashram literally got off to a flying start, initiating participants into a powerful yogic technique for balancing Samana, one of the five major energies circulating in our body.
The Samana is a particular air process which is responsible for the air to move all over your body. From this point to this point to this point, the whole body. We have 21 points, 10 fingertips in the feet, 10 fingertips in the hand, and Sahasrara. In all these whole 21 points, the air being flooded, this is called Samana. That process is called Samana. If that Samana is balanced, is proper, whenever I give you this kind of one idea and ask you to sit with it, the extraordinary powers will start expressing in your body, like a feeling very light, or feeling heavy, feeling expanded, or feeling shrunk. These are the four called Anima, Lahima, Mahima, Karima. In the Ashtama Siddhis, eight Siddhis, these are four. All of you are clear what I am saying? Anima, Lahima, Mahima, Karima. These are the four important powers. First, it will happen psychologically. Then it will become physical. See, you will feel little more than you are. First, psychologically. Then, even physically, it will start happening. Physically, if you are levitated, you have a healed Samana. If you are only psychological levitation, you don't have any wound in Samana. But if you have neither psychological nor physical levitation happened, means your Samana needs to be balanced now, needs to be healed. I'll now put you through the simple process how the Samana healing, Samana balancing happens. But of course, you will go through heavy process from tomorrow to balance Samana permanently.
Already a Siddha, an adept in the science of levitation, Nithyananda released powerful anima energies into the air to help participants take the leap into levitation. Anima is one of the Ashta Mahasiddhis, eight mighty yogic powers known only to the Siddhas and Yogis of ancient India.
See, actually what happens, what is initiation? When I say, let that process, you just sit with that process, means that simple understanding of fish. With that one simple understanding, be there. When I say that, just through this Kurmanadi. Kurma Nadi is the Nadi through which you release or receive. This is a center Nadi. See how you check, when you check blood pressure, this is the exact Nadi on which you put the machine. This is the exact Nadi which runs through this middle finger. This is the Nadi through which you send or receive information. So just through that, whatever experience is in my body is released. So any body which has Samana, balanced Samana, complete healed Samana starts levitating, catching it. Balanced Samana, psychological levitation happens. Little imbalanced Samana just tries to catch that wave. This is what exactly happens. Now, understand, you are not expected, you should not be waiting for levitation, you should not be doing it. You just be with the process I am saying. Let that happen by itself, because levitation, it is only one side effect. There can be many other side effect of, side effect, when I say side effect, you should understand the right way. Not as is described in allopathy. Not as it is described in allopathy. Levitation is only one byproduct. There will be so many byproduct. There will be so many byproduct. The body will expand. So there are things like a Lahima, Mahima, Karima, Anima, different Siddhis. So with samana balancing, with this initiation, any siddhi part will start happening in you. Any siddhi will start happening in you. So just be empty space, allowing this process to happen in you, this initiation to happen in you. That's all I wanted. Now, all you need to do is balance your samana and leave this process in you. Do not expect which one should happen in you. You understand what I am saying? Do not expect only the levitation should happen in you. Because the levitation itself can happen with along with 2-3 things. You can feel heavier than what you are, and levitation can happen. All of you understand what I am saying? It does not need to be only that you should become light and levitate. No, you can become heavy and levitate. And same way, it does not need to be just feeling smaller than what you are and not having the levitation. You can have smaller than what you are and levitation, or bigger than what you are and levitation. 2-3 things can match and mix, mingle and move. So all you need to do is just be open with samana balanced and available. That's all. See, I am not now teaching you levitation. Please understand, I am teaching you enlightenment. As a byproduct, these 4 can happen. Anima, Lahima, Mahima, Karima. All 4 can happen. So be open to it. Be with it. Let's see what happens. You will suddenly see there is every possibility, not only levitating, the stability can become at least few seconds. Maybe 10 seconds or 20 seconds, your body will be able to stay.
Within moments of the initiation, dozens of participants were leaping effortlessly into levitation, while many others experienced states of expanded consciousness. Today's process was one of over 200 techniques revealed to Nithyananda during his 53 days of illegal imprisonment. Levitation happens as a result of the energy alchemy between master and disciple. As anyone who has tried it will tell you, levitation is not a joke. It is the science of defying the massive gravitational force of the earth. Anima is the yogic science of making oneself smaller than an anu, an atom. Of course, this is not a physical process, but involves the mastery of subtle cosmic energies. The science of levitation is mastered only through decades of unstinting practice, vigorous physical and mental discipline, and extraordinary tapas or penance. But in the gracious presence of the Guru, the need for all previous practice simply falls away. Just by connecting deeply to the master's energy, participants who had never before experienced yoga were soon enjoying both physical levitation and psychological expansion. Such indeed is the power of the master's grace. I am literally transmitting my bio-memory to you, said Nithyananda. However, Nithyananda cautioned participants against getting caught in the achievement of levitation.
My name is Nagme. I live in Los Angeles. I'm a board-certified chiropractor, spine doctor. Also, I have board certification on reflexologies of the hands and ears and the feet. And my original background from Iran was obstetrics, delivering, natural delivery. Simply Swamiji, he's sitting there and he's watching us, and few simple words he utters. Without us knowing any technique or any sutra, any mantra, nothing. Just simply says the simple life solutions. And then right there, this levitation happens. It's so automatic, so innocent, and so natural.
My name is Debbie Chance, and I'm from North Carolina in the USA. And I'm a school administrator. And I have been a school administrator for many years, and I specialize in brain research. So I've become a consultant, so I travel across the country in different places and talk to school administrators and social workers and guidance counselors and teachers. It's been really unique with Swami because having this experience of levitation is something that's very simple and easy. And when you have that thought that you can't do it, then you can't do it. So if we have conflict-free living, conflict-free life, then we're not creating our own resistance patterns, and our brain patterns become liquid and soft, easy, so that when Swami drops that slight bit of energy into our brain thought pattern, we just immediately let go. And we lift off the ground. It's just complete relaxation.
It is such an intense rush of bliss that happens from the point of contact, your body's point of contact with the floor. It's such an intense, immense amount of bliss, happiness, joy, that you just want to go up. And it just pulls you up. So this is what I have been experiencing.
And the way it feels is an expansion, a very strong expansion, where there's space between your molecules in your body. You just feel light, like a cotton fiber, like a feather. And you see a feather that's just floating in the breeze. So there's this feeling of lightness, there's a feeling of unboundedness, so that there's no sense of any boundaries, and there are no thought forms. But there's a huge amount of force that's coming up through your central part of your body, it feels like. Sometimes it's in other parts of your body. It doesn't have to be in the central. It can be anywhere. But you allow it. It's a matter of allowing. The key word really is allowing and not resisting. So living that energy and letting your body just experience pure bliss. It's a state of pure bliss. And what Swami does is he just drops that thought form into our minds that are completely relaxed and feeling that emptiness, and then the bliss stimulates that surge of energy that makes the levitation possible.
Such a beautiful, amazing, pure and simple feeling that you just want to be one, become one with universe. It's such an innocent way of experiencing the existence and becoming. We are part of it, but we kind of know ourselves separate from existence. This is how we just become one with the whole cosmos, the whole energy. Just want to, you know, you feel so light that you just want to get up. Come up. So.